You mentioned telomeres a few times. So for people listening or viewing that aren't quite familiar with telomere biology, maybe you can give a quick just, you know, background on what telomeres are and why they are involved in the aging process, mm-hmm. what are biomarkers for aging.
Mm-hmm, sure. So people like to think of them as like the aglets at the tips of shoelaces, those plastic caps to keep shoelaces from fraying. So when you think of our linear chromosomes, they're all capped at the ends with this wound up strings of DNA, repeating DNA, called telomeres. And they are protecting the genome from damage. So they're very important that way. They are sensing chemical signals of stress in the cell. And so if there becomes a toxic situation, they think the cell is in danger, they are going to, well, that cell can shut down to protect the body. But also the telomeres get worn down very quickly when there's a lot of stress. And so stress biology and aging biology are actually really tied up intimately.
They take the hit, so they're trying to protect your DNA from potentially acquiring a mutation that could lead to something like cancer.
Yes,
so they
you.
Sort of take the hit for the cell.
Right, right.
In your experience, how much would you say that telomere length, so you know the telomeres get shorter with time, and shorter telomeres are supposed to, you know, correspond to aging. How much would you say that telomere length regulates the aging process, like actually plays an active role, mm-hmm. versus just is a biomarker, something mm-hmm. that's just biomarking the aging process?
Yeah, that's a good question. So telomeres are one specific pathway of how a cell ages and how our tissue ages. And the pathway is this. It's called replicative senescence, and it's basically how long can that cell continue to divide and replenish into new, fresh, young cells. So the telomeres, when they get too short, prevent that particular cell, whether it's an immune cell or a neuron in our hippocampus or the lining of our cardiovascular system, we need those cells to replenish throughout the decades. When the telomere gets too short, that cell stops dividing. And so it's basically a little window into how long can these cells continue dividing. If the telomeres are long, they have a long potential for replenishing tissue.
So it sounds like the telomeres are much more important in stem cell populations that are really responsible for replenishing variety of cell types,
right,
and variety of tissues.
Right, absolutely.
And mm-hmm. So there's a, you know, would you say that there's a difference between how telomeres shorten or, you know, what the attrition rate of telomeres in stem cells are, mm-hmm. versus other cell types that
yes,
are not stem
yes,
cells?
Yes, yes, yes. So if we could measure stem cells more easily, we would realize that partly what we're measuring in any tissue is the health and longevity and telomere length of the stem cell. So the stem cells lead to progenitor cells, and then there's all the offspring. And so when we look at blood, we're looking at the offspring in the different circulating cells that roughly reflect the health of the stem cell. Mm.
And there's a variety of different, so you're talking about the damage that happens with age and how that can accelerate telomere shortening because they sort of take the hit. Mm-hmm. They're protecting our DNA. There's an enzyme that can rebuild telomeres, mm-hmm. right?
Right.
Can you talk a little bit about that
yes.
enzyme? But it's not active in every cell,
right?
Correct?
So the telomerase enzyme is a very interesting enzyme that is intracellular, that is has the ability to actually rebuild telomeres by adding back base pairs. So it's a RNA reverse transcriptase. And this was discovered by Liz Blackburn and Carol Greider and colleagues over 25 years ago. And they were showing how if you knock it down, the cells cannot divide anymore. And if you upregulate it, the cells become immortal. So it is an important regulator of how long a cell can divide. It's one of the major determinants of telomere length, because if your telomeres shorten and you have a lot of telomerase, you can repair them, you maybe even can lengthen them.
And telomerase, if I remember correctly, it's more active in stem cells than in somatic cells for
right.
the most part?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so at UCSF, my colleague Julin actually has an assay that's very sensitive and can measure the level of telomerase in our normal blood cells. They're not cancerous, they're not stem cells, but you can still measure the level. And that is associated with health, with metabolic health, with socioeconomic circumstances.